One of the coolest machines out there are Rube Goldberg machines, and Spin Master's Wonderology has an entire kit series based off of these crazy contraptions. And this kit here is specifically the Robot Factory Challenge, and this is what we're going to be building in this video. Machines are crazy cool complex contraptions that are set to do just a simple task. And you'll find Rube Goldberg machines all over the internet. There's competitions with them of who can build the best, see who can build the largest, and now we even have kits. So we have this kit here by Spin Master's Wonderology, which you can find at Target, and they have an entire series of Rube Goldberg machines that you can build. But this one that I have here is the Robot Factory Challenge. So first off, I want to point some of the things that are on the box that I find pretty cool. So first off, I find it pretty cool that they have a cartoon version on the front, and on the back, they do have a real life version of what it's supposed to look like. But probably the coolest thing that they have on this box is that on the bottom, it gives a real life Rube Goldberg machine that Rube Goldberg, who of course the machines are named after because he was the creator, has, and that he actually drew. And I found that pretty cool because it gives an example of what they originally were. Now I'm super excited to build this one because this one looks super cool. And so of course the first step that I'm going to be doing is unboxing it and knolling out all of my pieces, and I'll explain what knolling is in just a second. Try to put everything into sort of 90 degrees. And I learned this from my friend Allie Weber over at Technic Allie Speaking. So basically, this was a little bit hard to knoll out because they have some really funky shapes going on, and this looks like going to be a lot of fun. So here are all my pieces, and of course I have my instruction sheet that will be telling me how to put it together. I'm super excited to test it out, but while I was building it, I did have problems with one thing, and that is with the green arm inside of the hole that attaches to the red parts. There's a flat side inside of the hole, and there's a flat side that it matches to on the red part, but in the instructions, it doesn't really instruct that very clearly, so that's something you have to look out for. So of course, the next thing is testing out, and I'm super excited for it, so I'm going to clear off the other parts of the table, otherwise in the contraption, and we'll see how it works. Alright, so the first step in this crazy contraption is to roll this basketball into the tiny scientist Rube Goldberg, which then lets go of the nut that's on the back of these legs, which then makes it roll down the ramp onto the platform. And the legs cause this white ball to roll down the yellow ramp all the way back here to the hard hat, which rests on a lever. And because of the gravity of the ball and the weight of the ball, it pushes the one side of the lever down, which then pushes the other side up, which in consequence pushes this bottom side of the silver arm, which is another lever, up, and pushes this part back, which then allows this red spinny thing to go all the way down the pole because of gravity and eventually hit this yellow arm, which then allows this box to go down the track because of gravity and allow the torso of the robot to flip onto the feet. And then the torso of the robot also hits this lightning bolt, which then knocks that off, which then allows this arm, which has a spring in it, to flip on over to put the head of the robot onto the rest of the robot, which then allows the robot to walk on forward. And that is how the contraption is supposed to work. Alright, so now it's time to test out this crazy contraption and see if this thing will work. Alright, so as you can see, that didn't work perfectly well. And ironically, the problems with the green arm is what I was having issues with earlier. And what's happening is that the spring inside of this green arm is too weak to fling the head onto the rest of the robot. And I actually looked onto the how-to video that Spin Masters produces on their YouTube, and this is a problem that a lot of people are having. Some people are even having the opposite problem, is that the spring is too strong and is flinging the head. I can probably think of one way that they could fix this, and that's putting a sliding weight on this end to move the center of gravity. And I could probably do that with the stuff back here, but with it being a kit, I shouldn't have to do that. I can think about three ways they could do this to keep it child safe. And there's also another problem with this kit as well. It looks like they included something after producing this kit. And I kind of know that because, look, these are the smaller instructions that were included, but they were not mentioned in the original instructions, and that's why you don't see me putting them on in the video. There's actually three here on the underneath of the base and one on the bottom side of the robot head, but there are a few issues with these sticky dots. One is that they're super sticky, so once you use them, you're probably not going to use them again, and where would you get more sticky dots after you use all of the ones that they give you? So then you would have to try to figure out how to do it yourself, and that's kind of an issue. But there are a lot of things I really do like about this kit. Like, I love the color scheme. It's really bright and colorful and fun. And I especially love this model here of this tiny scientist Rube Goldberg. It looks really great. And I also love the idea of this kit. Rube Goldberg machines are really cool and awesome and fun to have. But there are a problem with a few things, and so because of that, with this specific kit of the Robot Factory Challenge, I think that this is a no-go, even though that I think that this is a really good idea for a kit. I probably think that my favorite part of this kit would be what the robot would have done if it really did work. Like, actually, let me show you what would happen. So, let me put this off to the side and put the head on, since there is a switch on the robot. As you can see, that was really cool, and I absolutely love a lot about this kit. I love the design, I love the artwork, I love the idea, but because of the issues, this one is a no-buy.